Okay, let's turn our attention now to working with Excel documents. What I'd like to use as an example here is data from the Electric Reliability Council of Texas. This is an organization that manages the flow of electricity to millions of Texas customers. They also provide a lot of publicly available data sets on things like load or the amount of electricity that's used by their customers. This is one such example for the calendar year 2013. A lot of organizations publish this type of data, and often they will publish it as Excel documents. What that means for us is that we have to have a way of programmatically working with Excel, because many times we'll want to process dozens or perhaps hundreds of files, all of which have been published as Excel. What I'd like to introduce you to here is a Python module called XLRD. XLRD allows us to work with Excel files, whether it's the old XLS format or the new XLSX format. This module will allow us to read in all of the data from an Excel workbook and work with it in any way that we need to in a Python program. There's also an XLWT module, which allows us to create Excel files if we need to do that programmatically. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do before we dive in and take a look at this example code is actually go through and run it. Okay, what I've done with this program is produced output that illustrates a lot of the features that you might want to work with when using XLRD, when processing Excel data. So one of the things I'd like to illustrate here is how we can read our data from an Excel file entirely into a Python list and work with it. How we go about working with rows and columns and individual cells in an Excel file using the XLRD module. And then finally, a little bit of information about dates. This is primarily because of the way that dates are represented in Excel that we need to talk about this. So let's go back and look at this code. Here we're simply specifying which file it is that we're going to load. In this case, it's an XLS file, an old format Microsoft Excel file. Okay, and then the bulk of the work that we're doing here is actually done in the parse file function. All right, so this is the command we use to open a workbook, and you'll note that we're using the same variable name here. Okay, and then we need to specify which sheet we'd like to work with. So here we're selecting the sheet 0, and you'll find that XLRD is entirely zero-based indexing. So the very first column is actually column 0, the very first row is actually row 0. Okay, here's an example of doing a list comprehension. And in this case, what we're doing is essentially looping through all of the rows and columns and reading all of that data into a Python list. What I'm doing here then is simply printing out the value of row 3 and column 2 for this list that we've just generated. Now if I scroll down a little bit, we can see that following the list comprehension piece, what we're doing here is looping through the entire sheet one row at a time and then moving across the columns. And the way I've set this up is that once we get to row 50, what we're going to do is essentially print out all of the values in that particular row, one column at a time. Now again, this is a piece of code that does nothing more than simply illustrate the functions and methods that you'll want to work with when using XLRD. In the next piece of our example code, I'm illustrating how to work with rows and columns in XLRD. All right, in this case, what we're going to do here is we're going to simply grab the number of rows for this particular sheet, and then we'll print that out. All right. This is an illustration of how to check the data type or the value type for a particular cell using the cell type method for sheet, for objects of type sheet. Okay, and then cell value, this actually gets the value that's stored in that cell as the appropriate Python value, whether it's a floating point value or something else. And then finally, this is actually a pretty cool method. Here we can slice the values out of a particular column. What that means is that we can say, okay, I want three values from this particular column, and I want to start on row 1, so actually the second row down, and I want to go through rows 1, 2, and 3 up to row 4, but not including row 4, and I want to take those three values sliced out of that particular column. Okay, and then here we are doing something very similar to what we did here, which is actually checking the type of the value in a given cell. But in this case, we have a date in this cell, okay? So we're going to pull out the cell value. Now, it turns out that in the old Excel format, dates were represented simply as floating point numbers. So what we can do is use the XLRD date as tuple method to get us that time in a way that allows us to work with it as a date in Python. Okay, let's go look at that output one more time. Okay, so here's our list comprehension. We're simply printing out the value at row 3, column 2, from the list into which we read all of the Excel data. So here we can see where I was looping through the rows and columns and printed out all of the values on row 50. Okay, and then number of rows in this sheet happens to be more than 7,200. All right, now note here that the type of data in cell 2 is specified as 2. You can look up, if you want to, in the XLRD documentation exactly what all of these different type identifiers reference. In this case, it's a floating point number. We can see that the value that we've got there is 1,036 and change. Okay, and here's the output from having taken a slice out of column 3. Okay, so here's that piece where we were working with dates. Now, XLRD does distinguish the fact that that particular cell holds a date, but here's the time represented as a floating point number. Okay, what we can do is convert this to a Python datetime tuple using that XLRD method that I showed you. And this gives us a much better representation of the data that we're interested in. So in this case, what we've got is row 1, column 0. So it's that very first cell at the top. Okay, this one here. All right, and note that what we're pulling out there as the value is, in fact, year 2013, January 1st, 1 a.m.